Hey guys, welcome back to the Comic Book Lowdown, where I review comic books and comic book story arcs. Today is the special Tropical Storm edition of the Lowdown, because I am where I'm at. I'm in a tropical storm right now, and that's why I didn't have school today, so I can bring you guys this video. But enough with the meteorology, and now back to the comicsology. Today I'm reviewing Deadpool, the Dead story arc. This is part one of five parts, and this was actually the first Deadpool comic I ever bought. I haven't been into comic books for that long where I buy them regularly. I had always liked them, but that's another video. I want to review Deadpool, and just to start off with, really like the character in general. I first learned about the character in the video games, Marvel Ultimate Alliance, the first one. Got really good with that character in that game. So anyways, to start, before this was the evil Deadpool, where Deadpool fights a clone of his evil self, and then at the end of that, his evil self gets killed. Now, we know that Deadpool cannot be killed, so obviously that there's something wrong, because, first of all, evil Deadpool's face turns back to normal, to a regular face, unlike how Wade Wilson's face is all messed up and he always wears the mask. So something is up, and we go into detail with this, story arc. And yeah, so let's get to it. So to start off with, where we start off 5 months ago, it says right at the top, 5 months ago, and you just see them talk, these guys talking about, and they're talking about a storage unit. So the taller guy, the skinnier guy, he's a detective, and he's going through storage units, and he's looking for something. And he gets a phone call talking about if he's found anything yet. And he then finds a baby book. And right now, this part, you don't really know what's going on until the whole story pans out and you find out the importance of this. But he finds a baby book, and then that's when you get the previous page and all that. I really like this issue because, like, it's really funny. You just see Deadpool being really pissed off about how he didn't die. You see, there's the flashback on here with, regular Deadpool, evil Deadpool. And evil Deadpool's like, how am I dying? And you just see Deadpool is, like, kicking himself. He keeps on saying that evil Deadpool stole his death. And he's like, oh, it must have been some kind of, like, serum thing that negates healing factors. And that's what it, in fact, is. That killed, or helped kill evil Deadpool. So, now that was 4 days ago. The one thing I have about this issue is that it jumps around times way too much. The start of this is 5 months ago. Then you tune into 4 days ago. And then you go back to today, where in today, Deadpool is talking with X-Factor, his X-Factor team. And I think it's really cool. He makes everybody out to be a chess piece, because his plan is to find out who has the serum, how he can get it, and eventually get himself killed, because that's what he wants the most. But he doesn't know that, or he doesn't know who has it, he doesn't know who fired it off, and he doesn't know how he's gonna get other people to know that he's still around, because whoever shot off the serum thinks that Deadpool's dead. But really, they got the wrong Deadpool, And so now he needs to get himself known, but he can't put himself out there because the cops are after him after what happened in the Evil Deadpool story arc before this. So, a lot of story to go with this. This is not an easy thing to review because there's so many moving parts. But anyways, back to it. So, he's using all these characters as pawns. First of all, he's using the X-Factor team. And he goes to them saying that he needs help getting the serum because he says that the Kingpin has the serum and the Kingpin's gonna use it against all mutants to negate their powers, and so that gives X-Factor the initiative to go after the Kingpin and then kill the Kingpin before he uses the serum on mutants. And I think it's really funny because they have Psylocke try to read Deadpool's memory, or not his memory, his mind, and he realizes that they're trying to do that, so he just starts going off on weird tangents when he starts talking about Drew Carey. And then he starts talking about how Kingpin's name is Wilson and his name is Wilson, so he thinks that's cool. And so it doesn't work what Psylocke tries to do. But then here's another time jump. It goes from today to 2 days ago where he's going up to Hydra Bob, and he's asking Hydra Bob for help too. And what does it say here? Oh, he says that Hydra Bob says he's not gonna help him because the last time he did anything with Deadpool, Deadpool shot him. And Deadpool says that that's what friends do, or that's what pals do. So I think it's really funny. So Deadpool says that Hydra Bob wants to help him, and Hydra Bob says no, he doesn't, but he kind of does. And so to make Bob want to help him, Deadpool shoots him again, which I thought was pretty funny. And then another time jump goes back to today, where their plan is to go out, look for the serum. See, back to today, they go out, look for the serum, and they want to keep a low profile, so yeah, because they don't want to blow their X-Factor cover, and also Deadpool is pretty wanted in all of pretty much the US. So they need to stay low. Then another time jump to 3 days ago from today, so 1 day before meeting with Bob and 1 day after his fight with Evil Deadpool, I guess. It gets a lot simpler with the later issues with the whole time jumping thing. This is, again, the one thing I have wrong with this issue was that it jumps too much. So three days ago from today being where he's talking with X-Factor, he's talking with Dawkins, Wolverine's son, and he's asking him for help, saying that Dawkins might know who has the serum, and he wants his help to shoot Deadpool with the serum. But Dawkins pretty much just refuses, but he hopes that Deadpool does die. So, in a funny scene right here, you have Deadpool talking to Death, and he says, he always calls Death baby, and he says that he promises that he's gonna do it this time, and Death is just like, no, don't promise me. And eventually they just have a that's what she said joke in there, so it's pretty immature, but I like it. Back to today, again, another jump. So back to today, and Psylocke's questioning Deadpool because she doesn't trust him. That's pretty much what that page was about. Then another time jump, they go to yesterday where Bob is talking to the Kingpin about, and Bob pretty much says that if anybody's gonna know who has the serum, it would be you, because you are the crime lord, master, whatever. And Bob puts his feet on the table, and you see the shot wound on his leg. And Kingpin's like, if he shot you, Bob tells Kingpin that he wants to kill Deadpool. And Kingpin asks why he wants to kill Deadpool. And he says that because Deadpool's always shot him a bunch of times. And so Kingpin says, so you guys are friends, because if he's shot you a bunch of times and you're not dead, that means that you guys are friends. So, and Bob's shocked. Kingpin asks why he's shocked, and Bob pretty much just says, because that's what Deadpool said. And so, after he's just begging with Kingpin after a while, Kingpin gets pretty tired of him, and he gives Bob a couple chances to leave, and Bob just, like, is like, huh? And so eventually Kingpin just throws him. I thought that was pretty funny. And then he goes away, and it's Kingpin and Typhoid Mary. So there's a lot of characters in this. So Kingpin and Typhoid Mary, and he tells Mary to go out and find the serum. And so now you have Deadpool's looking for the serum, X-Factor's looking for the serum, Kingpin is looking for the serum, and I'm guessing Dokken is looking for the serum. So you got a lot of people with a hand in all this. And speaking of the hand, Kingpin deploys the hand. So now you have, and right there, so now you have the hand in this issue, or in this story. So, that's pretty much the story. Deadpool wants the serum, so he manipulates a bunch of people, his team, the X-Factor, and Kingpin, and Dokken so far. Oh, and Bob, into doing what he wants. Very complicated story to explain, but to read, it's understandable. There's more time changes after this, the last one I mentioned. This is hard to understand because when you're dealing with days, it's okay, it's a lot easier, but they go into like minutes on here, so it's like 18 minutes later, and then that night, and so again, just the thing that I had a problem with was that it just always jumped around. And here's an important part. So Wolverine gets into contact with Nick Fury, and he asked for a list of sniper names in New York City that could have been the ones to shoot the serum, trying to kill Deadpool. And he gets a list of names, and four names, and he cancels out two of the names after they go searching for evidence on who might have shot him. So now they got two choices, and once Deadpool knows the choices, he teleports away, and he handles his own business. And so when X-Factor gets to one of the snipers, they find him tied up and dead. And they originally think that Deadpool killed the guy first. His name is Van Buren. But they then notice that they're not alone, and it was Typhoid Mary and the hand that that killed the sniper. And then you have a scene where Dokken is talking to somebody. Dawkins is talking to the guy on the phone in this first scene. Whoever this guy is talking to, he's on the phone with. Dawkins is now talking to that person. And Dawkins pretty much saying that he knows that whoever it is has the serum, and he pretty much wants in on it. And the guy, whoever he's speaking to, denies that he has it, and so Dawkins just leaves. And then Deadpool mentions how he has all the chess pieces set to Bob while they're on a rooftop over here. I guess that's where Deadpool teleported to. And now all they do is wait it out and see how everything plays out. And then you get in the final page, scientists talking and talking on the phone, and he's talking to somebody, whoever made the serum. He's talking to the person, he says, and the person's asked, how much more the serum can you make? And you eventually find out that the reason for the baby book was to have a strand of hair in the baby book from a first haircut that people put in the scrapbooks or whatever. So that's for that. And then off the phone, you find out who originally had the serum made, and it was Tombstone. Tombstone hates Deadpool because Deadpool had him put in jail for a while, and now Tombstone wants to kill Deadpool. I think it's funny that on Tombstone's phone, he has the scientist's name as scientist. Not a specific name, but it just helps you know that that is the scientist that he's talking to. So anyways, this issue does a pretty good job in putting the story in place. It does feel like the longest issue in the story arc, just because there's so much to it, and they needed a basis to put the whole story by. But it's still pretty good. The only thing I didn't like is all the time jumps from yesterday to today to 4 days ago and all that kind of stuff. That's the only thing I didn't like about this. But anyways, Deadpool issue 50, the first part of the Dead story arc, pretty good. In the later issues, you don't have a problem with the whole jumping around. It's just in this one. But yeah, so this is a pretty good issue. Pretty good way to start off the story. And yeah, so another video coming up soon. Part 2 of this review. Gonna be a 5-part review. I don't really like to do this, but if you want to, subscribe to my channel. I will be putting out videos as regularly as possible. I'm gonna try to do more reviews. I've got a lot of comic books, but not a whole lot, not like a bunch of other people have. Again, I'm just getting started, but I do have a couple that I can get around, and I do have some online issues, I do have a lot more online or issues on my computer, so I will be doing videos where I don't have physical issues in my hand. But anyways, that's the part 1 of this review. I'm Wellington Reyes with the Comic Book Lowdown, and I'll see you guys next time.